Many years ago, people learned to code on paper, then came computers, and now generative AI. With tools such as ChatGPT, Bard, and many other tools like this, learning to code has never been easier. Recently, I got assigned to a project where I had to work in Scala on some big data. Scala is a programming language which is primarily used to build data-intensive programs. I learned it many years ago, but since I never used it since, I completely forgot. So I needed a refresher. I was amazed how fast I was able to pick up the language again after many years with the help of generative AI and tools such as ChatGPT and Bard. So in this video, I'm going to focus on how you can learn any coding language fast using ChatGPT and any other generative AI tools. I will be sharing my framework, prompts, and any other tips and tricks that you might need to know while you're learning. All the prompts that I'm going to be using today, I'm linking it in the description below, so feel free to download it if you want to try it on your own during the video or after the video. If you haven't heard about ChatGPT yet, you are probably living under a rock. For those who don't know, ChatGPT is a natural language processing tool that allows users to interact with it and receive responses in a natural language. It is based on GPT architecture, which is a type of a language model that has been trained on a large human-generated dataset. Think of it like a personal assistant, but the AI version, and it's free. You can use it however you want. I personally have been using it as a tutor to learn new things fast. That includes learning to code and new subjects. Sometimes I think of it like talking to a smart coworker who's sitting across the desk, but I don't want to go and bother them. So I type on my computer and ask them questions, and I get the responses back. And they basically help me write new code, debug the code, learn new concepts, and find information on the internet quickly without the embarrassment of actually asking my coworker. Okay, I'm just kidding. It's okay to ask your coworkers. So in this video, we're going to be focusing on learning Python. Python is a very diverse language, and it's easy to learn. If you're just starting to learn to code, I would suggest to start with Python. I'm going to be mixing and matching using ChatGPT and Bard, because now Bard also has coding abilities. So you might see me switching screens here and there, but for you, the framework is not going to change. So the first thing is we're going to do is we're going to define a roadmap for learning Python using ChatGPT so we can narrow down our focus on what things we need to learn. Okay, so the first question I'm gonna ask it, can you give me a study plan to learn Python for data science? Okay, so it's giving me a pretty generic roadmap. It's giving me information, but it's not specific, it's too generic. So I want to make it more specific. Let's say I have 8 weeks to study. So I'm going to tell it, make this study plan 8 week. I don't know why I have the caps on. Make this study plan 8 weeks. Cool. Now it has started to give me a weekly Python roadmap, and it is more specific than what I got earlier, which is really cool. So it's focusing on NumPy's, pandas, data visualization, matplotlib, scikit-learn, and capstone project. I think we can do better. There is a few more things that I want to try. So the next thing I wanted to ask is to include resources and links. It's including courses, Python documentation. I still feel like this information is a little too generic, so I think we can do it better. This is typically how people ask ChatGPT questions, and you can see like it gave me a super generic response, but what a lot of people don't know is how to ask the smart question. So that's what I wanted to do this video and show you like how you can actually ask smart questions and basically ask ChatGPT to give you good answers instead of generic answer. So I wrote this prompt where we're gonna make ChatGPT act like a Berkeley professor, and then we're gonna tell it like we have only 10 weeks to learn Python, so like make sure like you give me a super relevant curriculum. Do you see like how now the responses that I'm getting are way more specific, way more detailed, which is really good. Okay, so let's say you have defined your roadmap, you have defined your study plan, and you're working on it. I truly, truly believe that in order to learn anything new, especially coding, you actually need to get hands-on experience to learn it. Because you can watch all the tutorials, you can watch every YouTube video on the internet, but unless until you actually do the hands-on work, you won't be able to learn it fully. So what we're going to do next is, let's say we're learning Python, ChatGPT has given us a roadmap. Now we want to do some hands-on project. So this is where I would again ask ChatGPT to give me hands-on projects on Python so I can like kind of get hands-on experience, but also like build my portfolio that I can show to other people to show that like I actually do know Python. So I wrote another prompt where I'm asking it again to act like a Berkeley data science professor. I don't know what's with me and Berkeley professor, but whatever. And then I'm giving it a lot more specific information in terms of that we have very limited background into Python. And then I'm asking it to include projects in each week so a student can get hands-on practical experience. It's actually acting like a Berkeley professor, which is really cool. Okay, so I think it's giving like very generic response. So I wanted to add more requirement for each project. So I'm going to ask it to do that. So now that I have run that, now it's actually giving me a lot more specific project guidelines. For example, let's read project one, Introduction to Python Basics. So create a program that calculates and print the areas of a circle. The program should take user input. Okay, now this is a lot more specific. I still think you can like build on top of it and get even more detailed project requirement. But for the purpose of this video, I think this is enough. So let's say if I were able to follow all of these, I would have 8 projects after learning to code and then having hands-on experience and something to add on my resume. Let's say you're working on these projects and now you are on week 2. During week 2, you are assigned a project where you have to do some data analysis using Python, SQL, Excel spreadsheets, which is also actually a great opportunity to try this AI-based spreadsheet by Quadratic HQ, who is also sponsoring this portion of the video. The tool is completely free and it changes the way you work with your data in spreadsheets. You can basically write code inside your spreadsheets using Python and SQL and many other languages. Not only that, it has integration with ChatGPT, so you can actually ask ChatGPT questions inside the spreadsheet and work on your code. You can use it to build dashboards, create internal tools in minutes, quickly mix data from different sources, as well as explore your data for new insights. I'm gonna link Quadratic in the description below. It's completely free. So talking about resume, I think there's one more thing that we can do. So let's say we worked on these 8 projects. Now I want to include these projects on my resume. So what we're gonna ask ChatGPT to do is we're gonna make it create bullet points for us for each of these 8 projects. So let's do that. So I'm gonna say, create resume bullet points for all of these projects. And of course, like the answer that it's gonna give is gonna be a little bit generic because it's not gonna be specific to your project and the actual outcome from your project, but this is actually a great starting point. You can actually copy paste this into your resume and then modify it and customize it to whatever you want to add to it. Now that we have defined the framework, we have built our project portfolio, at least like you know what your projects you're going to be working with. The next thing you can do is have it explain specific concepts to you. Let's say you want to join 2 datasets in Python. Here I would ask, actually let's try Bard for this example, and this will actually give me a coding snippet that I can use and customize further. Okay, so it actually gave me a coding snippet that I can use. Okay, so basically I got coding snippet as well as output. Oh wow, okay. This is really cool. ChatGPT doesn't give me output, but I got an output from a sample output from Bard. Okay, this looks pretty neat. Next, let's say you have some SQL code and you want to turn that SQL code into Python. This is especially helpful for people who are coming from other coding language. For example, let's say if you use R or if you use SQL or if you use Java or C# and you have some coding snippet written in that language, you can use ChatGPT and Bard to actually switch the languages. So in this case, we're gonna switch the SQL to Python. So I'm going to give it a SQL code and I'm gonna ask it to convert it to Python pandas. So let's see what it does. Okay, so it understood the SQL code and it gave me basically a coding snippet as well as the output. Okay, I love the output. The output is the best part. Let's try another example where we have some complex SQL and we're gonna ask it to convert this code into Python again. So this one is using inner query and the output, yay, okay. Okay, it looks like it did a really good job running this code and taking that complex SQL, semi-complex SQL into Python code. Also, I really like that there is a read SQL function that is in pandas. You can basically write your SQL inside Python, which is really cool. You can also use ChatGPT and Bard to explain specific concepts in Python, such as while loop or if statements, else if statements, and anything that you're having a hard time wrapping your head around, you can actually use it as a tutor and basically learn new things. And sometimes I like to give it specific prompt where I say that explain it like you would explain to a child. And it really, I don't want to say dumb it down, it really simplifies it for you, which I love. And I have done that a few times. Another thing that you can make ChatGPT do is make it write new code for you. Now here, I would say that if you're learning to code, this is your first time, I would suggest that you write the code on your own and then verify with ChatGPT or Bard to see if this is actually the right output. Because once you actually write it on your own, you actually get to learn more. So I wouldn't just go to ChatGPT or Bard or any of these tools as the first step. Try to do it on your own before you actually get to any of these tools. Some other use cases that you can try ChatGPT is to write documentation. Let's say if you have some code and you want to write documentation on your code, you forgot to comment on it earlier, but now you want to add comments, you can ask ChatGPT and Bard to write comment your code. You can also have it write documentation for you. There are so many other use cases that you can use these generative AI tools to your advantage. And this video is just covering only 10% of this. I would suggest to watch some of the videos that I published earlier, how you can use ChatGPT and generative AI tools for your work, for your learning in data science, data analytics, and coding in general. So feel free to watch my other videos where I go into more detail. Let's say you learn this coding language to get a job in coding, and let's say you have an interview coming up. Here again, you can ask ChatGPT to give you a framework, a question, set of questions that you can practice on that specific coding language. There are obviously a lot of positives to these tools, but there are certain limitations to ChatGPT and Bard. One of them is that it's not always right, so make sure that you're doing your due diligence when using any of the output from ChatGPT, Bard, or any of the other tools. It's based on historical data and based on things that have already happened, so it's not going to give you any out-of-the-box ideas, but it's possible that it might give you some ideas that you haven't read on the internet today, so it's your sandbox. You can use it to find ideas that have other humans have come up with. And obviously, it goes without saying, be responsible when you're using this tool. For example, don't put your work code on any of these tools because it will become part of the training model and your work might not like it. Let me know in comments if you've been using ChatGPT, Bard, or any of the generative AI tools for coding or other use cases. With that, thank you so much for watching. I hope you're having a great day. I will see you in the next video. Bye.